In this video, we will explore the UVW map modifier. Open a new 3ds Max scene and create a box. Let's say that this is a wall and I will make it 20 cm by 200 by 300. Try not all the sides of your box to be equal so that you can understand the technique that we will see now. Let's open the material editor and apply a V-Ray material. And add a diffuse map that has a pattern. I have selected a brick texture. Don't forget to enable So Shaded Material in Viewport so that you can see the texture in the viewport. If you are wondering, I got my texture from textures.com. The PBR menu. And I went to the Bricks category and chose this one for our example. So what do we notice here? That the texture doesn't appear to be equal, to have the same size in every side. And if we notice it carefully, we will see that the texture stretches to fit in each side. If we go to the box's dimension and change them, you will see that no matter the size, the texture always stretches to fit the size of the box. If we go to the coordinates rollout and play with the tiling values, we can adjust the size of the texture but we keep having the same issue. We can't make the size of the brick of this side to look equal to the size of the brick at the front. That's when we need to use the UVW map modifier. In 3ds Max, UV and W stand for the X, Y and Z axis. You can see the X, Y, Z axis at the bottom left corner of its viewport, and we can also see them when we select an object. There are a lot of different ways that we can adjust the UVWs, but the UVW map modifier is the easiest and simplest way. Select the box, go to the Modify tab, click on the modifier list, scroll down and select UVW map. And now it looks worse than before, but don't worry. So why does it look like that? If we check the parameters of the UVW map, there are several ways of mapping. The default one is planar. And if we quickly go through each option, you see that the way the texture is projecting on our object keeps changing depending on the mapping method. Let's go back to planar. So what does planar mean? See this plane over here that appeared the moment we added the UVW map modifier? The planar mapping means that our texture will be projected on a flat plane. And for you to fully understand this, I want you to go to the Modify tab and to the UVW map modifier. This modifier comes with a submenu. That's what the arrow means next to its name. Click on the arrow and the gizmo option appears. Select gizmo. When enabled, it gets this blue color and the XYZ axis move to the center of the object where this plane is. If we drag the cursor, the texture moves accordingly. The model itself is not affected. We are not moving the model. We are moving the texture on the object. So, when Gizmo is disabled, if we use the Select and Move command, we move the object. When Gizmo is enabled, if we use the Select and Move command, we move the texture and the way it projects on the object. Let's drag it to the side so that you can clearly see the plane shape. As I said earlier, the planar mapping means that our texture will be projected on a flat plane. With the gizmo enabled, if we now choose the Select and Rotate command enable the angle snaps and rotate by 90 degrees. Now the texture applies accurately on the front and back view, but not on the sides. Flat plane means that there are no sides, so no matter how we will rotate the plane, it can never project on all sides of the box at the same time. When we have boxy shapes, and now we literally have a box, we need to use the box mapping. Now, the texture projects on all sides, and we see here that the reference shape is a box, but it still doesn't look correct. Let's see what other parameters do we have here. The length, width, and height values define the size of the texture. If I type 100 by 100 by 100, I am setting each side of the texture to be 100 centimeters. Let me also open the photo we downloaded. So, I am letting the software know that this side is 100 centimeters and this side is also 100 centimeters. Now, it's good before we go and type values to first do the math, so that we are putting in correct values. What do I mean by that? Let's take a look at our photo. And let's assume that each brick is 22 centimeters long. So, since we have 10 bricks in a row, this side must be at least 220 centimeters plus the gaps in between each brick. That being said, I will come to the length, width, and height values and make them 240 centimeters each side. This one now is more accurate. Now, the texture has the same size on its side, but on the sides we don't have the correct orientation. To revise that, enable Gizmo and choose the Select and Rotate command. Make sure the angle snap is enabled so that you can rotate by specific degrees. If we right-click here, we can set the degrees we want to rotate by. Click on the red circle and rotate by 90 degrees. Now, this is perfect. Below the length, width, and height values, we see the UVW tiling. In these fields, we set the amount of times the texture will repeat. So, if I make the U value 2, I am asking the texture to become twice as dense on the X axis. If I make the V value 2, now I have scaled down the full texture and made it twice as dense. Once we have set the correct scaling of the texture, we can use the Select and Move command to move the bricks around if needed, so that we don't start and end with half a brick. You can also use the Scale command to adjust the size of the texture, but this is something in general I wouldn't advise you to do, simply because then you lose track of the size of your texture. Here it shows 240 centimeters, and no matter how you will scale it, this value doesn't get updated. If we have moved the gizmo and click the center button, it will center it to our object, but then any adjustment we have made on the position of the texture is lost and restored to the default one. Same goes if we hit fit. Then, the size of the texture matches the size of the object and so it stretches to fit its side. A useful command here is the bitmap fit. When we click on it, the Select Image dialog box appears and we need to select our bitmap. The size is not correct, but the shape is. What do I mean by that? The size of the UVW mapping adjusts to the sides of the texture we loaded, so it informs us that the original bitmap has a square shape. For you to understand this better, let me load another image. This wood texture. Which you can also see here that This one has a rectangle shape and not a square one. So if I hit again the FitBitMa button and load the texture, the UVW mapping adjusts to the new shape. As I said before, the size is wrong, but this helps us understand the correct proportions we should be keeping. And if I make this 200, now I'm starting to stretch the texture and distort the proportions. Enough with this box. Let's now open a scene, and we can open the one I shared with you in my last video. I will also copy the link in this video description if you want to use the same file. Let's open the material editor, create a new V-Ray material, and apply the same brick texture we were using so far. And let's apply it to this wall. Hit the Show Shaded Material in Viewport, and we will notice that our texture doesn't show up properly. It basically looks like a color. When a texture doesn't show up properly on your object, use the UVW Map modifier. Select the wall, go to the Modify tab, click on the modifier list, and select UVW Map. Choose Box, and you see the same issue we were talking about before. We will make the size of our texture 240 cm for each side. Then we will enable Gizmo, select the Select and Rotate command, and type in the Y field 90 degrees. That's perfect now. So, if we now want to make this wall the same brick, apply the material, and here we are again. Instead of repeating all the steps, what we can do, since this texture has the same attributes to this one, is to simply select this wall, right-click on the UVW map we applied, and choose Copy. Then, come to the new wall, go to the Modify tab, right-click on the Editable Poly, and choose Paste Instanced. Now, the settings match, and any changes we make on the UVW map of one of the walls, the other one will get adjusted at the same time. The box mapping doesn't refer only to boxes, but any shape that is boxy. So for our sofa, we would also use the box mapping, or for our curtains. But the more complex our geometry is, the more problems start rising. What do I mean by that? Let me select the sofa and isolate it. And let me assign a texture with more apparent pattern. Let me put a UVW map, select box, and make it 20 cm on each side. So, if I zoom in, you see that we have some issues with the geometry and the texture doesn't really unfold properly. So, if we want to make a close-up render over the sofa, then UVW map is not enough in this case. When we don't do a close-up, maybe it could pass like that. But for a close-up shot, we need to use another modifier, the unwrapping UVW map, which is quite a difficult technique, and we will cover this in another video. I hope now it's clear how you can use the UVW map modifier. Thank you for watching. I will see you all in my next video.